Everyone, I'm Marina from Yes to Tech, and welcome back to my channel. Have you been wondering how to make a GIF so that you can create custom GIFs for your Instagram stories? In this video, I'll show you how to make a GIF of a graphic, as well as how to transform yourself into a GIF and upload that GIF onto Instagram. By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to make GIFs for Instagram so that you can add custom GIFs to your Instagram stories to get you more views, click-throughs, and conversions. If you're excited about this video, make sure you like this video, hit the subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a new video. And with that said, let's jump right in. The first kind of GIF we'll be making is of a graphic. To do so, head over to Canva, which you can try out for free by clicking on the link in the description box below, and use the search bar to search for Instagram post. When the Instagram post option populates, click on it, and then select the blank template. You can either use one of Canva's pre-designed templates and make that into a GIF, or design your own GIF from scratch by using individual elements. To make a GIF from one of Canva's pre-designed templates, click on the template you like to add it to your design area. Just like with any regular Canva template, you can click on any elements on the page to customize them, such as the background, text, and images, or click on any of the options from the left-hand side panel to add new photos, elements, and text into your GIF. For more details on how to customize a Canva design, make sure to watch my video on how to use Canva. I'll leave the link to it in the description box below. Once you're happy with how your original design looks, click on Duplicate Page above it. To transform the static image into a GIF, change a few elements on the second page, such as their position or color. For instance, I'm going to invert these colors. Once you're done customizing your GIF created from one of Canva's pre-designed templates, rename your Canva design up top . Click on Download, and then click on Download once more. To design your own GIF from scratch using individual elements, create a new Instagram post design in Canva by following the same steps as before. Click on Elements from the left-hand side panel, search for an icon you like, and then drag and drop it onto your design area. To transform the static image into a GIF, just as before, click on Duplicate Page above your design and change a few elements on the second page, such as their position or color. This time, I'm going to rotate the image 90 degrees. Once you're done customizing your GIF created from individual elements in Canva, rename your Canva design up top. Click on Download. Make sure that this transparent background option is selected, which you can do as a Canva Pro user, which you can try out for free by clicking on the link in the description box below, and then click on Download once more. Before transforming these images we just created in Canva into a GIF, let's shoot a mini clip and transform ourselves into a GIF. The higher quality camera you use, the better this will work, but I'll be using my phone camera for demo purposes. So use the video option on your phone to record a mini clip of yourself, such as pointing up to mimic the swipe up feature, and then click on Edit up top to cut the beginning and end where you're clicking the record button. Send yourself that video file to your computer. If you don't know how to do that, make sure to watch my video on how to transfer photos from your iPhone to a Mac. I'll leave the link to it in the description box below. Head over to a website called Cloud Convert to change the file type from MOV to MP4. and then head over to a website called Unscreen to remove the background of that video. Once the background has been removed, save this new clip to your computer. Now onto the fun part. It's time to transform all of the designs we created into GIFs to then add them to Instagram stories. Head over to a website called GIF Maker and then upload the images you downloaded from Canva as well as the video you just created, each design at a time. After the images from Canva have been uploaded, you can change the canvas size, change the animation speed, select how many times this animation should repeat itself, as well as add music if you so wish. Once you're done editing your GIF settings, click on Create GIF Animation. Once the GIF has been created, click on Download the GIF. After your video has been uploaded, adjust the start time, end time, image width, image height, and frames per second settings, and then click on Convert Now. Once the video has been converted into a GIF, click on Download. To add these GIFs to your Instagram stories, transfer these GIFs to your phone. Again, if you don't know how to do that, make sure to watch my video on how to transfer photos from your iPhone to a Mac. I'll leave the link to it in the description box below. And then open up your Instagram stories. Take a picture or open up the picture you wish to add to the GIFs we created to, then open up the GIF on your camera roll. Select the share icon on the bottom left, click on copy photo, and then when you open up your Instagram story, you'll see an add sticker option on the bottom right. Click on that to add your custom GIF to your Instagram story. You can now resize and reposition your GIF and copy any other GIFs you created from your camera roll to add them to your Instagram stories. If you're serious about making a GIF to create custom GIFs for your Instagram stories, make sure you check out our free content calendar with 30 days of Instagram content ideas below this video to learn more about how you can get more views, more click-throughs, and more conversions. Make sure you comment below and let me know what kind of GIF you'll be adding to Instagram. If you liked this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below for new videos every Tuesday and Thursday at 9:45 a.m. Eastern, and stay tuned for our next video, which is about how to outline pictures for thumbnails. As you wait for my next video to go live, check out these two videos I have right here, and I'll see you in my next video.